ancient representations of reality were sort of a weird meld of observable phenomena, things that we would consider objective facts, and subjective truth, the projection of subjective truth. And I'll show you, for example, I'll show you how the Mesopotamians viewed the world. They had a model. Basically, the world was a disk. You know, if you go out in a field at night, what does the world look like? Well, it's a disk. It's got a dome on top of it. Well, that was basically the Mesopotamian view of the world, and the view of the world that the people who wrote the first stories in the Bible believed too. And on top of the dome, there was water. Well, obviously, it's like it rains, right? Where does the water come from? Well, there's water around the dome. And then there's land, that's the disk, and then underneath that, there's water. How do you know that? Well, drill. You'll hit water. Well, it's under the earth, obviously, because otherwise, how would you hit the water? And then what's under that? This fresh water. And then what's under that? Well, if you go to the edge of the disk, you hit the ocean. It's salt water. So it's a dome with water outside of it. And then it's a disk that the dome sits on. And then underneath that, there's fresh water. And then underneath that, there's salt water. And that was roughly the Mesopotamian world. And you see, that's a mix of observation and imagination, right? Because that isn't the world, but it is the way the world appears. It's a perfectly believable cosmology. And the sun rises and the sun sets on that dome. It's not like the thing is bloody well spinning. Who would ever think that up? It's obviously the sun comes up and goes down and then travels underneath the world and comes back up again. There's nothing more self-evident than that. Well, that's that strange intermingling of subjective fantasy, let's say, right at the level of perception and actual observable phenomena. And a lot of the cosmology that's associated with the biblical stories is exactly like that. It's half psychology and half reality, although the psychological is real as well.